The threat of global warming is a myth. Well, actually, that will be true if it is still a threat in 10 to 15 years. Global warming is far from a myth, but the threat is becoming more and more of one as we advance technologically. This is because there is a cure to our environmental ills that doesn't involve clean corn, clean coal, or fuel-efficient cars. It is an almost completely unknown alternative that has no publicity, which is why it has to be discussed on my channel. It has been for many years considered a nuisance, and it has been used as an ultimate insult. This future savior is nothing more than scum. Literally. Algae is the simplest eukaryotic single-celled organism, and next to fungi is the most diverse. Scientists know about 0.5 to 1% of all fungal species on the planet, and probably just about that much for algae. If our understanding of the little green slime was expanded, our abilities to live in harmony with this planet would be increased exponentially. Algae is highly versatile, because different species fit different niches and harvest and secrete differing chemicals. At the moment, scientists are working on species of algae, combinations, and systems that will produce diesel, gasoline, ethanol, butane, and jet fuel. These are all the fuels we rely on now, directly converted from CO2 and sunlight, and require no change in the technology we are currently using. Algae also has another major advantage. It doubles its mass in a day. Compare that with corn and you will easily see how much better it is. Studies show that the same amount of biodiesel from a football field of corn can be produced in the space of the size of two garages. On top of this, algae does not need a flat surface, just a tower with a lot of sunlight, so it could produce a lot more fuel than this depending on how high the tower can be built. Even better, these towers could be built in just about any town or city in the US, generating jobs and never again relying on overseas fuels. Algae also has many other uses that, as side effects, will sequester CO2 and greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. It can be used as animal feed, nutrients, rayon, nylon, or just be buried in the ground to either sequester the carbon or decompose, producing natural gas. If algae was used in cattle feed, then beef could possibly become carbon neutral, instead of being a huge contributor to our ever-warming planet. And lastly, algae has the ability to clean both water and air. Universities are using polluted wastewater from factories to grow algae in and are producing extremely good results. Some algae even sequester sulfur, which is a major lung pollutant of coal factories and diesel big rigs. It has been estimated that if a coal factory was to set up a filtering pond the size of a parking lot to generate and harvest algae, it would be both carbon and sulfur neutral, protecting both the earth and our health. So why does no one know about this? Why haven't you heard on the news about this apparently amazing innovation? Money. Big oil in the Middle East will be out of money in a heartbeat if algae got even the fraction of the funding we spent on the Iraq War. Mega-subsidized Big Agro wants to make a killing off producing genetically modified corn, using the small farmer as a shield and icon from anyone who might oppose them. Corn would go back to being a food source and not a fuel. Algae is barely listed as an option for a viable alternative fuel source unless you dig for it online, and it gets barely any of the money set aside for alternative fuels. Not even Al Gore has given it so much as a nod in discussing climate change. So if you're sick of being worried about climate change, worried about our brave men and women fighting wars for oil, if you're sick of land and water pollutants, or don't believe in global warming and are just sick of hearing about it, write and call your local congressman or senator and let them know that algae research is where we need to put our money for a safer, cleaner, healthier, and much more peaceable planet.